Okay, we're gonna start this, and I'm sort of nervous, but okay.
Woke up at 11 o'clock, I ain't got no job, what the hell should I do today?
Hello guys, my name is Chai, welcome to my channel. So today I'm going to share with you what I think about Pamela Reeve's 45-minute workout plan after doing it for 3 weeks. So before we go into this review, in case you don't know who is Pamela Reeve, or Rife, I don't know if I'm pronouncing her name right, but she's basically a fitness YouTuber where she posts free workouts and she has a really large following, and I heard a lot of good things about her. Like, she has really good music, really effective workouts, and personally I tried her workouts once or twice before this, but I always wasn't that drawn to it because she doesn't talk as much. But I'm not going to deny that her workouts are hard AF, and recently I've been having really bad insomnia, and I suspect it might be because like I'm not having as much physical activity right now. So I want to really just tire myself out during the daytime so that I can have a restful sleep at night. So yeah, if you're interested to see what I'm going to eat, my progress and all that, keep on watching. For 3 weeks, I'm going to do a different version of the 45-minute sessions each week. So for the first week, I'm going to do the dance version. Second week, I'm going to do the slow one. And the third week, I'm going to do the sweaty version, because I was just pretty curious as to what's the difference between all three versions. Okay, and you realize this after doing her workouts for like maybe during the second week. And I realized that all three of them are more or less the same. It's just that out of 4 videos in one day, maybe one or two will be a bit different depending on which version you choose. But I still think that does make a difference depending on your workout preference. So I'll still just give a brief comparison of the style of workouts, the difficulty, and how I feel and what I think about them. If you don't actually want to know what's the difference between all these 45 minutes because you maybe just want to do the beginner workouts or the 30-minute workouts, I'll also give a review on what do I think about her workouts in general, because I think all three have a very similar vibe as well. But if you're hoping that I would tell you to do Pamela Reeve's workouts for 3 weeks and you'll get abs or a bigger booty, then this is probably not the video for you, and I will tell you why later on in this video. But that being said, I still linked my results, after clips, whatever you want to call it, down in the timestamp below. So if you just want to know if I got results, to know what I think about her workouts, click onto that and see if you still want to watch this video, because I just don't want to waste your time. And without further ado, let's go on to the review. These are my abs over here. I've been eating crap recently, so the tummy pooch, but it's alright. And now we're going to take measurements. 25, I think. Okay, let's start off with talking about the dance workouts. So instead of doing those typical intense cardio moves like burpees and jump squats, the cardio here I think is mainly in the dance routines. So for every day, you would get to at least dance for 10 to 15 minutes out of the 45 minutes, and the remainder of the time, it would be mainly Pilates or some form of strength training. Although she sometimes incorporates moves like squats or jumping jacks into her dance routines, no.
Most of the moves are pretty easy to follow, and I usually don't get too out of breath when I'm doing it. But that being said, all her Pilates and strength training workouts are killer though. Most of the time, I just feel like dying, as you can see from the clips over here. Overall, I would say the entire week was pretty chill, and I think the dance routines are a good way to incorporate cardio if you're someone who really dreads jumping and intense cardio. Time goes by really fast.
45 minutes just flew by.
And I didn't mind it too much since I was still recovering from a sprained ankle. But that being said, after this entire week of chill and zen mode, I surprisingly craved a really sweaty workout. Like, you know, the kind of sweat you get from a very intense workout session. So yes, we are going to move on to the next review, which is her 45-minute slow workout.
I can't formulate myself here, so I'm doing my best.
Even though this version has one or two dance routines on the first day, I would say that the slow version is more similar to the sweaty one. On most days, both versions had identical workouts. But what I really like about this version is that even if she includes hit moves like burpees, she makes it really low impact. So for example, instead of making you jump into the squat, she will make you step into it like this. I personally prefer this a lot more because my knees didn't hurt at all during the workouts, which allowed me to go all out because I wasn't distracted by the pain in my knees. Overall, I have nothing bad to say about this version because I think it strikes a good balance between me feeling challenged as well as not feeling the bad sort of pain, because I truly believe a workout doesn't always have to be painful in order to be effective. Maybe some people might find the slow pace a bit boring because she did include a lot of videos where she provided coaching on the moves, but I personally really appreciate the slow pace and the coaching because it allowed me to focus on engaging my muscles and I was able to learn the moves that I didn't know how to do in the other videos because I've never gotten a personal trainer before, so I found it really really helpful.
So after 3 minutes, my butt is still shaking, but we gotta continue with her workout, which is the inner and outer thigh one. So yeah, let's continue on.
Okay, so I went into this week thinking it would be loaded with HIIT workouts since she named it sweaty. But surprisingly, only half of the week involved some form of cardio, and my sweat mostly came from doing super super intense Pilates workouts. The only reason why I prefer the slow workouts compared to this is that she does make you jump during HIIT, but even then it's only for 10 to 15 minutes, so I think it's still pretty manageable overall. But somehow, out of the three, I still think this sweaty version workouts were the hardest amongst the three. Maybe it's her booty pump workout, like the new one, that really gets me. Like, I can tell from the videos that I am suffering a lot. And she even made us do it twice during that 1 week, and that workout is seriously no joke. I believe that video is only 10 minutes, but look at me here.
Okay, so to sum up my comparison, I think it's pretty obvious what would you choose after this review. If you just want a fun time and the least amount of pain when you're working out, then the dance workouts are probably for you. But if you're someone who wants your abs and butt killed, then the slow or sweaty version is probably the one for you. Or if you're like me who just hates burpees and jumping at home workouts in general, then definitely go for the slow version because you would really feel the slow burn, but I promise you'll feel so accomplished after that.
So now I'll just share a bit of my thoughts on how I think her workouts are in general.
First, what I just want to say that her workouts are definitely more focused on strength rather than cardio.
So if you want to focus on cardio, her sweaty version will definitely be your best bet. But even then, I think cardio sessions from Lily Sabri or even Caroline Gervin might be more intense because I remember how my heart felt like it was going to beat out of my chest when I was working out with them.
And workouts are definitely for intermediate to advanced level people.
For me, I hardly ever stop doing any workout if I can help it because I really just don't like prolonging my pain. But Pamela really made me feel like a beginner, especially during her 10-minute ab workout. I had to take a few breaks because there was seriously no more will in me to push through anymore at some point.
And second, I also want to emphasize how much I like her anti-workout structure in general because she actually includes warm-up and stretches. She actually puts an effort to include these at least like 3 to 4 days of her workouts.
In fact, you're only working out 5 days a week because there will be one day dedicated just for stretching. So yes, her workouts do give you a quick and painful death, but I like how she plans out active rest for you so that you can come back stronger during the last 2 days of her workouts because they tend to be much more intense than the workouts in the beginning of the week.
And thirdly, and the most important part of all at-home workouts in my opinion, is that I really like her personality, coaching, vibe, whatever you want to call it.
Although she doesn't hype you up with lots of screaming and cheering, she has that really calm vibe where she would quietly gesture you to push your butt up whenever she knows you're tempted to sink your butt down, which I find really funny to be honest. Plus, she doesn't edit out the bloopers in her videos, which I find oddly charming, and I don't know, it just makes her much more human and likable,
so
I guess.
I officially take back whatever I said about not liking how she doesn't really talk in videos, because I realized I just wasn't very fair to judge her based on those one or two videos I did of her in the past. Okay, so before we move on to the results, I'm just gonna explain to you why I wasn't even expecting results in the first place. And it's mainly because of the way I ate during the 3 weeks.
So a few days into doing her workouts, I suddenly realized that my birthday was going to be on the second week and Chinese New Year is coming on the third week. And like any normal human, I celebrated my birthday with the foods that I craved as well as my favorite cake. And like any Chinese, I had a full-on reunion dinner feast and snacked on a lot of Chinese New Year cookies throughout the week. And rest assured, I thoroughly savored and enjoyed every single thing that I ate.
Nice, right?
So very quickly, let's just see if I got any results.
Holy crap, wait.
Okay, so I wouldn't say that there's a big difference because the rest of my body remained more or less the same, but I was honestly still quite shook by my waist measurements.
I don't think that there's much difference, but you know? I've been eating pretty crap
still. And yes, there are meals or days where I eat healthy, but I also ate whatever I craved throughout the 3 weeks. Like, it could be ramen, ice cream, curry mee, McDonald's, like literally anything. So yes, this is actually to give a bit of context in case anyone came here thinking there are going to be drastic results from the 3 weeks I did this workout. Because I feel like whenever someone posts a fitness review, a challenge review, a workout review on the internet, it's always expected that you'll get some sort of drastic results. But personally, I have never experienced this sort of thing before, nor with my focus or intention in the first place. So that's why I just thought that I should share a bit about the foods that I ate throughout these 3 weeks to just give y'all a bit of an idea of what would happen if you just ate whatever you wanted.
Even with the way I ate, I'm not going to tell you to eat cake now, every day, for the rest of your life. Because let's be real guys, it wasn't very fun to have constipation for 5 days in a row. And it wasn't very nice when I constantly felt sleepy and gassy when I was having class because I was just eating too much crap. So what I'm trying to say right here is that you shouldn't eat healthy just because you want to achieve some aesthetic goals, but most importantly, you should eat healthy because it's better for your well-being in general. But that being said, I understand everyone has very different health or fitness journeys, goals or struggles that they are going through. So if you're someone who is constantly restricting and afraid to eat what you truly enjoy and what you want, I hope this video shows you that you can still achieve your goals slowly but surely while eating things that you love, because it's really all about balance and consistency. And for people who are like me, who find it hard to eat healthy consistently, I hope my tiny story would give you at least a little bit of motivation to take better care of yourself, because this is my health goal for the year, which is to learn how to like eating healthier, like in a genuine way, not in like the I want to lose weight way. And lastly, I so hope you found this review video helpful if you're thinking of trying Pamela Reeve's workouts or are just wondering how her workouts are in general. So let me know if you think that there are other fitness YouTubers that I should try or review. And thank you so much for taking your time to watch this. I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye bye.